I just want to cover, should you jailbreak, should you not? Of course, click on those videos if you haven't already. You know, it is a good thing to watch through just because not everybody knows everything there is to know about jailbreaking, and there's a lot of important topics to cover. This jailbreak is semi-untethered, so if you guys turn your device off or lose power, you will not be able to open up Cydia or any tweaks without going into the app, clicking on the circle, and clicking the power button. It takes, what, like 20 seconds each time, so it's a very, very convenient jailbreak. Don't think of the semi-tethered jailbreak as a detriment. Really, it's not. So, guys, I'm so excited to show you how to do this. It is so, so simple. First off, I'm gonna grab my unjailbroken iPhone 6S Plus on 9.3.3, and just to confirm that I am running that firmware, there it is, with Night Shift and everything. And wow, guys, I'm just so blown away by this. But anyways, I want you guys to navigate to this website right here, webflames.net/jailbreak/. So I'll have a link down below. Make sure the J in jailbreak is capitalized, otherwise it will not load. So once you do have this loaded on this page, it's as simple as clicking install, install the PP jailbreak. And using this method, you don't actually have to put your Apple ID in, so it's verified right away. Really, it's a little bit safer than other methods. However, this may stop working if the app is ever, you know, just not signed anymore. But in that case, you would have to go to the computer and do the jailbreak with a computer. But for now, it is working perfectly, and you guys do not need a computer. Go ahead and click on this. Well, actually, we can't open it yet, so let's go into settings, and we're gonna go back into general, scroll down to device management, find that profile and trust it. So this is the real deal. Don't be sketched about anything. We're gonna jump right back into it and make sure to select okay to notifications. This is part of the exploit. Click on the circle and you should see this text and just click the power button and that's it. So your device should light up and you should see a little prompt. So this will take about 1 to 2 to 3 minutes. And just leave it. Don't touch anything. You can go in, but there's really no point. Your device is doing the jailbreak in the background. In a moment here, it will respring and we will be fully jailbroken on iOS 9.3.3. By the way, this works on 9.3.2, 9.3.1, 9.3, 9.2.1, and 9.2. And it's only for 64-bit devices. Probably should have said that in the beginning, but iPhone 5, 5C, iPhone 4S are not supported. And as far as I know, the iPad Pro 9.7 and iPod Touch 6th generation at this point in time are having some difficulties with this jailbreak, so maybe that'll be patched in a future version. Okay, so no response, there we go. So the device has just resprung, we slide over, and boom, there is Cydia on our device. Don't worry, this isn't a scam, this is the real deal working Cydia. So I'm gonna simulate real quick what'll happen if you turn your device off. I'm gonna turn it off real quick. So after restarting, nothing will work, none of your tweaks, not even Cydia will open. So you wanna go into this P jailbreak tweak, and here you wanna go ahead and select okay, and select the ring once again. So just like last time, we're gonna lock the device, and it's gonna go through its process again. This time it will be faster. It's the first time that it takes, you know, the longest amount of time. Now it's going to be much faster. So this is basically what you need to do every time your battery dies or you restart your device. Really not a deal breaker by any means, but you know, a little bit of an inconvenience. Hopefully they can figure out how to go around this, but if they don't, not so bad. And guys, upon opening Cydia, I want you guys to search for Apple File Conduit 2 and install this right away. This is a crucial part of the jailbreak, and for some reason it's not installed right away. So you do need to install this to ensure that the jailbreak runs properly and smoothly. And guys, I thought I'd throw this in here as an alternate method. You can use iOS emus, so the link right here, I'll have it down below as a second method. After downloading the main app, inside of it you will find the same exact application. So PP jailbreak can be installed from multiple sources. It doesn't need to be exactly specifically this one, but so far it's been reliable. Other websites just go down, but this one has been up. So yeah guys, there it is, how to fully jailbreak your device on iOS 9.3.3 within the comfort of your browser. That is amazing. So major props to Pangu, everybody who made this possible, guys. I'm just blown away. More tweaks coming soon. Have a great day. Enjoy the jailbreak. Peace.